A month later, Bankman-Fried was arrested in the Bahamas and extradited to New York to face federal charges that he had fraudulently used customer deposits to finance billions of dollars of venture capital investments, real estate purchases, and political donations.
What's your response to someone who hears this and says, it's a fun story and it's crypto in the Bahamas, but this is the oldest architecture of a financial collapse that's been going on for centuries?
This isn't a Ponzi scheme. Like, when you think of a Ponzi scheme, I don't know, Bernie Madoff. The problem is there's no real business there. The dollar coming in is being used to pay the dollar going out. And in this case, they actually had a great real business. If no one had ever cast aspersions on the business, if there hadn't been a run on customer deposits, they'd still be sitting there making tons of money.
So there, by not challenging Lewis on the points that he just made there, 60 Minutes was certainly not doing a hardball interview, nor even a slow pitch softball interview. They dropped the ball altogether by not challenging him on those points. And so that's what I'm going to do here, attempt to challenge if I was the one doing an interview. And I'd point out to Michael Lewis, the author, that, you know, a Ponzi scheme is just one type of financial fraud. So Lewis seemed to imply that just by, given the fact that it was not a Ponzi scheme, which is true, just because of that does not necessarily mean it wasn't another type of financial fraud. So that was like he was making a straw man argument there. So that was never the claim that FTX was a type of Ponzi. Like, Ponzi is just when the new investors, new money that's going into an investment operation is being used to pay out old investors so they get their promised returns. But, you know, any kind of financial fraud that involves where the business uses customer money in a manner different than what the business told the customer what they'd be doing with that money, if they're using that money for something else, then that's financial fraud. And so that's what the narrator, right before Mr. Lewis started speaking, the narrator explained that this SBF is being charged with using customer deposits to fund billions of dollars of venture capital investments, real estate purchases, and political donations. So yeah, those are the charges against SBF while he was running FTX. And so they're to be charged with using the customer deposits for something other than what the business told the customers what they'd be doing with that money. And so yeah, that's still financial fraud. Yes, it's not a Ponzi scheme. That's not a Ponzi scheme. Necessarily, if those funds are not being used to pay the promised returns to old investors, then sure, that's not a Ponzi scheme, but it's still a different type of financial. It's still a type of financial fraud, So what point is Lewis making when he says, when he's trying, sounds like he's defending FTX by stating, quote, and referring to FTX at the time that everything went down, Mr. Lewis states, in this case, they had a great real business. If no one had cast aspersions on the business, if there hadn't been a run on customer deposits, they'd still be sitting there making tons of money. One point there is that it doesn't matter if they're a real business or not. They're still, the allegations are that they're committing financial fraud. You know, a business can, the false choices say they, well, either can be a real business or it can be it has to be either a real business or a fraudulent business engaging in financial fraud. They both can be occurring simultaneously, but a business can both be taking in money legitimately, making legitimate profits, taking in legitimate revenue, and be engaging in financial fraud at the same time. So it just be, even if they're, it may be well be true that they're running a real legitimate business, it doesn't necessarily mean they were not engaging in financial fraud. And also, there's it still could be the case that, I would ask also, Mr. Lewis, the question, don't you think that there's a possibility that the allegations are true? And if so, couldn't it be possible that maybe misusing all those customer billions of dollars of customer deposits had something to do with the fall of FTX? Don't think that's a possibility if the allegations are true. Yeah, that those, you know, spending they're spending money hand over fist. FTX was on all these sponsorships, incredible amounts of money. Political donations, and they're giving money to these, you know, sponsoring these athletes and naming a stadium. Those venture capital investments. That's the allegation is that they're misusing the money for kick. The customer deposits for venture capital investments and real estate purchases and political donations. You know, if those allegations are true, couldn't it be possible that had something to do also with the demise of FTX? That there's a reason. You know, those aspersions, maybe they had some. They were cast against FTX. Maybe they had some actual legitimacy to them, and if they did, then wouldn't that have something to do with the reason for the run on deposits, that there's something fundamentally wrong with FTX to begin with? But 60 Minutes interviewer, well, if he did ask them any questions, they did not include it in their in the story, at least not the one that they posted on their official account here on YouTube. And so I'm wondering why. Why wouldn't you challenge? Those are some real important claims that and arguments that Mr. Lewis was making. Why didn't they challenge him on it? In the least, they did not challenge him at all in what was released here on the video. And I'm not sure why. So that's why I'm putting this on here. And so that's just what I wanted to present to here for now. And hopefully that will provide some ideas here, and if you still watch, so yeah, thanks for watching. I'm hopefully I think I have some sort of laryngitis, and I'm not sure why, but hopefully that'll get better soon. But yeah, I like to make some more videos, and so if you're still watching, thanks for watching.